Select any object in Affinity Photo. Go to the Layers panel and right-click and select Duplicate. Once you've got that, go over to the Transform panel and you've got the current value, which is in this case 414. You can put plus, say, 70 pixels. That will change a value and you'll see the object, the duplicated object, moved. What you can now do is a power transform, and you can do that via Layer and Duplicate Section, or use Command J or Control J, depending on your operating system. And that will repeat that object. Now, each one of those objects have been moved by 70 pixels. Select any object in Affinity Photo and go over to the Layers panel, right click and select Duplicate. Go up to the control bar and you can see a little crosshair or transform origin. Make certain that is on. And if you have, you can see that transform origin there. And I'm just going to drag that down just below the shape. That's the duplicated shape. What I can now do is go to the transform panel and I can go to the R field. And I'm going to enter plus 10. Could be plus 20, plus 30, or minus 10. Doesn't matter. Press return and you can see it's rotated. What you can then do is you can go to Layer and Duplicate Selection, or Command J, Control J, as before. And you can repeat that. And you can repeat it multiple times, of course. Go all the way around, maybe create a semicircle, or go all the way around to finish off your circle. Once you've done that, of course, you might decide, you know what, I want that to be grouped or combined. What you can do, you can always go to Layer, down to Geometry, and go to Add. So with Add option, select that, and you can see now all have been combined into a single shape. Select any object in Affinity Photo using the Move tool. Go to the Layers panel again, and right-click and use Duplicate. Then go to the Transform panel, and you can go over to the Width field. What I want to do is enter maybe minus 10%. So minus 10%, so I can put a percentage sign there. And you can see what happens because these are linked. You can, of course, separate them if you want. You can just deselect that to separate them. You can then power transform again. So Command J, or just go to the Layer menu and Duplicate Selection and repeat that multiple times. And you create a quick zoom effect. Select any object in Affinity Photo using the Move tool. Then go to the Layers panel, right click and select Duplicate. You'll notice there's a little transform origin there. What you can do, you can reposition it. If you can't see that, go to the control bar. There's the option there, make certain that's on. And you can reposition it, position anywhere, or just keep it on the same position if you wish. Here in the transform panel, I want fairly small values. I'm just gonna put plus 5. So I want it to go from left to right, so plus 5. And for the Y field, I'm gonna put minus 5. I want it to go upwards. I know that seems odd, but minus 5 for going upwards. And here I'm going to go for the width, I'm going to go for minus 0.5. So you can put decimals in here as well. So 0.5%. Now it's not linked, so what I can do, I can put minus 0.5% there as well. You can see a little link there. And the R, I just want it to increase slightly, so I'm just going to put it to just 2. Now I'm going to duplicate selections. I'm just going to quickly go over here to Layer menu and Duplicate Selection. You can see I've got a shortcut. Now I'm going to use that Command J or Control J. And you can repeat this over and over again. So I'm just going to repeat it and you can see what happens. It just generates this lovely, very quick, relatively spiral. Now, of course, what's happened creates a lot of layers, lots and lots of layers. And you can see them all being created there in the layer panel. Layer menu is just quickly updating. You can see the spiral there. Now, with that spiral, I'm going to stop. Obviously, I could continue for quite a while. Now, I can select all those. I'm just going to move that slightly out of the way. Select all of those, and then I can go maybe Layer, and I can go to Geometry, and I can say Add if I want to join them all together. You don't have to do that, but you can say click Add, and then they become all one spot. However, if you go over here to the Node tool, you'll see you've got a lot. Unfortunately, there is no smooth feature to use with this, so you can't smooth it to remove all these points. It'd be really nice if you could, but I just want to point out that they're there. Select any object in Affinity Photo using the Move tool. Go up to the Layers panel and right-click and select Duplicate. Then go to the Transform. Now you'll notice in the Width field, I've got 150. So what I want to do is enter 150 or 160, 170, something greater than the size of the design. So I'm just going to go plus, and in this case, I'm going to go for 170. I want a bit of a gap. If you don't want any gap, put 150. So 170 there, and you can see it's now moved. Now I'm not going to enter anything in the Y value, but I'm going to repeat this using Power Transform. So Layer and Duplicate Selection, or Command J, Control J. And you can repeat this a number of times. So you can see now you've got this design all the way across. Select all the stars, all selected there, right click and select Group. Then go over to the Group and right click and Duplicate. Now you've got this duplicate. What you can now do, go to the Transform, and you notice the value is 150 there. What I want to do is I want it to go upwards, so I'm going to enter minus, a minus value. So it's minus 150, minus 160, minus 170, etc. So I want, again, minus 170. So I'm just going to enter that and press Return. Now I can go to the Layer and down to Duplicate Selection, or again, Command-J or Control-J, and repeat. And of course, once you've done that, you can select all of the designs, and again, you can right-click and you can group them, or maybe rasterize them, etc. Well, I hope you found this of interest. Any questions, please put in the comments below. Thank you much.